Henry VIII, during his reign as King of England, attracted great criticism at times for his changes to religion, and in particular with his break from Rome. Henry is known for being a notoriously brutal king, who would stop at nothing to get his own way. During his kingship, he would break from the Catholic Church due to the Pope's refusal to grant his divorce, close down hundreds of monasteries and religious houses to seize their riches for himself, and put down rebellions with acts of violence. When the north of England rose up in a protest known as the Pilgrimage of Grace, 30,000 armed men would march into York and demand that Henry opens the monasteries again and reverses his religious changes. Following the rebellion subsiding, the king would order the execution of more than 200 rebels to show his might and power and to show the danger of rebelling against Henry VIII's regime. Today we look at a man who spoke out against the king and suffered the horrific consequences. Join us today as we look at the brutal execution of Robert Hobbes, and remember to support our channel, please make sure to subscribe. Robert Hobbes was born around the year 1480, and not much is known about his early life or what happened during his childhood. He only really entered the history books and records when he rose to the position of the Abbot of Woburn Abbey in 1528. Usually inside these abbeys and monasteries, abbots were promoted from within, and extremely pious men who followed the teachings of their monastery could become an abbot. The abbot was the one responsible for the running of the abbeys and monasteries, and was in charge of ensuring that the religious order is kept in good routine, and is adhering to the rules and teachings which it followed. On the 27th of January 1530, after 6 years of being the Abbot of Woburn Abbey, Robert Hobbes applied and obtained for a royal licence for the Cistercian Woburn Abbey to hold 2 yearly fairs inside the town. This was granted, and these would be huge events, which would be the highlight of the year for the Cistercian order and the local community. On the 6th of April 1532, Robert was also commissioned by King Henry VIII to hold visitations and inspections of the Cistercian order within England. Now at the time, Henry VIII had grown incredibly tired of his wife, Catherine of Aragon. Their long marriage of over 20 years had not managed to produce a male heir or a son, in which Henry greatly wanted. He desperately wanted a son in order to continue the Tudor dynasty, and their marriage would produce one child who would live, a daughter called Mary, who would later go on to become Mary I, or Bloody Mary. Henry's attention previously had been caught by Anne Boleyn, a younger woman at court, who would refuse to become Henry's mistress. She refused to engage in relations with Henry VIII until the problem of his first marriage to Catherine of Aragon was sorted. The Pope at the time refused Henry's request for an annulment or a divorce, causing great frustration. Eventually, the king would break from the Catholic Church and would establish himself as the supreme head of the Church of England. In this role, he could basically do as he pleased when he declared that the Pope had no authority in England. And in November 1534, the Act of Supremacy was passed. This outlined Henry's new title, and also clergy across England had to acknowledge that the king was the supreme head of the church. Along with this, a Treason Act was passed at some point, which outlined that it was an offence to write and speak against the king and his heirs, and to accuse them of heresy. This was a common thing that could occur, with heresy being an incredibly serious crime. Accusing the king of being a heretic due to his huge religious changes could have been common, and all subjects were forced into accepting Henry's role within the church without any dissent. There were many across England who did refuse to take the oath of supremacy, including even those within the king's inner circle. Sir Thomas More, Henry's own Lord High Chancellor and best friend, refused to accept the king as the supreme head, and also the king's new marriage to Anne Boleyn. Because of this, More was even sentenced to death and beheaded on Tower Hill. Henry would later regret greatly this action. More said how he could not deny the authority of the Pope without jeopardising his soul to perpetual damnation. Robert Hobbes, the Abbot of Woburn Abbey, disagreed with Thomas More, and he did acknowledge the king's supremacy over the church, and also persuaded reluctant members of his abbey to agree with him, which at the time was a smart move. Henry, though, would take brutal actions against those who refused to accept his supremacy. For example, in June 1534, it was reported that the friars of Richmond refused to take the oath. Shortly after this, two cartfuls of friars were hanged, drawn and quartered. Also, the Carthusian monks were executed for the same offence, being executed in a number of horrific ways. Robert Hobbes was concerned at the time about these persecutions, and he found these incredibly disturbing and distressing. The persecutions would continue, with many more priors of religious houses being hanged, drawn and quartered for their refusal to accept Henry VIII's supremacy. Thomas Cromwell was also appointed the Vicar General, which made him the King's deputy with regards to the church. He suspended the authority of the bishops, and he began to order a series of inspections. Cromwell sent out investigators to look at the practices within the religious orders and buildings, and they were armed with 86 different questions. What they would do is inspect every part of the monastery in order to find any infringement and acts of poor behaviour. From this, if poor behaviour was found, then Cromwell would and could close down the monastery. The Act for the Dissolution of the Monasteries allowed Cromwell to shut down any religious house with an annual income less than £200, and with this the Crown and the King would pocket all of the money from these closures. Henry VIII desperately needed cash for his European military campaigns, and he saw the monasteries as an easy target to secure further wealth. Some of the investigations found rather poor behaviour within some of the abbeys, monasteries, nunneries, friaries and priories. For example, one abbot was found guilty of selling valuables, and another abbot was described as a drunkest knave living. What would happen is, following these reports of poor behaviour, Cromwell would shut down the order and seize their wealth and lands. The Crown would then sell off large parts of land cheap to nobles and merchants, and would take control of any valuables or finances. The dissolution of the monasteries is known as one of the most brutal land grabs in history, and in England it was one of the biggest land grabs ever seen. Monks and nuns were left homeless with their ways of life in pieces. Some were pensioned but became incredibly poor as inflation occurred. Also, a number of those who refused to give over their abbeys and accept the king's supremacy often faced time in prison, and also some abbots were even executed. Glastonbury Abbey's abbot, for example, Richard Whiting, was hanged, drawn and quartered on Glastonbury Tor, and to add insult to injury, his remains were then placed above his own abbey. Robert Hobbes, the abbot of Woburn Abbey, was initially safe. Woburn Abbey was not closed initially, but Hobbes became increasingly disillusioned and hostile towards the king, and in particular his religious policies. In 1537, Cromwell sent out his investigators again to investigate the loyalty of those abbots who were still running the remaining monasteries. These investigators often asked local people to assess what the abbot's opinions were. A former friar, William Sherborne, was interviewed about this in the local area to Woburn Abbey. Here, Sherborne accused Robert Hobbes of being a supporter of the rebels who were rebelling against the king's religious beliefs. Hobbes was then interviewed and interrogated, and he refused to recant and apologise to the king. It was said that Hobbes held firm, although in some places it is difficult to establish an exact meaning, from the long and rambling depositions of a man physically ill from strangury, and to disentangle apologies for bluntness of speech from repentance on points of principle. It is certain, however, that to the very end he remained opposed to the suppression of the monasteries, the distribution of wretched heretic books by Cromwell, and the royal divorce, all sufficient to make his conviction a formality. Indeed, he confessed his offences and offered no defence. So from this we can learn that Robert Hobbes was an ill man, and it seemed that although initially he did support the king, with the dissolution of the monasteries his opinion had shifted. Because of his opinion, Robert Hobbes was sentenced to death for treason, and was to be hanged, drawn and quartered. This execution method was particularly brutal, with the condemned being dragged through the streets of a local town, and then hanged from a scaffold until almost dead and then cut down. Following this, they would be cut open, with their entrails and insides ripped out and being burned in a fire next to the scaffold. After this, the condemned would be beheaded and also cut up into four pieces, with their remains being sent to different towns. This would then act as a deterrent, and this is exactly what occurred to Robert Hobbes. To add insult to injury for the abbot of Woburn Abbey, he was executed in such a barbaric way in front of his own abbey. Local legend states how he was also allegedly hanged from an oak tree at the abbey's gates. Chances are that following this, his head was placed above Woburn Abbey to act as a reminder to those to assimilate with the king's ideas. Woburn Abbey following Hobbes' execution was then seized by the crown, along with all its land and property. Robert Hobbes, the abbot of Woburn Abbey, went the same way as other abbots Hugh Faringdon and Richard Whiting. If you opposed the king, especially Henry VIII during the Tudor period, you were liable to the ultimate punishment, and losing your life for your dissent. Hobbes isn't as well known as the other abbots, but his story is certainly one which is worth remembering. Once again, thanks for watching. To support our channel, please make sure to subscribe, and once again, thank you so much for watching.